Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. The question came up in the forum, how would you create a rounded cornered rectangle? Well, there are three different ways that I know of, so let's talk about it. All right, starting with way number one, and this is by far the simplest way. I'm just going to add a plane, and I'm just going to mask that plane, and we'll put a checkerboard background so you can see on that. Under the mask, shape, expand it. When you expand it, it creates these little round corners, right? Let me fill that, and you'll see what I'm talking about. These little rounded corners, okay? So that's the easiest and simplest way. If you just want a basic rounded corner plane, or rectangle, I mean, that's number one. All right, let's do composite shot, new one here. And again, I'm going to bring in a new plane, and I'll just make that one white. I'm going to put a black plane underneath it, and again, I'm just going to put a mask on that. So now I have this white plane that has a mask over a black plane that doesn't. That's important that you have that black plane that doesn't under there. I'm going to look for a blur effect, and I will drop that onto the white plane, so it sort of makes it fuzzy and makes the rounders, the corners a little bit round. Then all I have to do is just add a hard edge to that sort of fuzzy gradient. And the way you do that is by adding a gray layer and put a threshold effect into the gray layer itself. Now, the advantage of this is that if you have that, then you can adjust the amount of the blur and it will adjust the rounding of the corners without adjusting where the edges are. Okay, so that's pretty slick. And of course, if you adjust the mask, then you will adjust how much or how what size that rectangle looks like. Okay, but then the question became sort of a, yeah, but what if I want an exact pixeled rectangle? Here's how you would do it. I'm going to, again, make a new composite shot. Click OK. I will drag in a plane, and I will make it white. So I'll just fill it white. And again, I will drag a black plane underneath that. Okay, now what I need to do is I need to create my rectangle. And I can use a plane to do that, or I can just make a new one. I'm just going to use a plane to do that. And what I will do is open up the transform properties, and under scale, maybe I want it to be exactly half and exactly 3/4 of the size. Okay, let's go 3/4 and half. Okay, so you can take the pixels that is wide and high of your shot, the 1920 by 1080, and you can figure out exactly what that is. Or you could just make a new plane and dictate exactly what size you want that to be and use it. That new plane, I'm going to rename the mat, and I will drag it to the bottom, hide it. And then I will use a set mat effect on the top plane, sourcing the mat effect. Now my procedure is the same. So I would add a blur effect to the plane, and then I would add, starting by adding a gray layer, and then add a threshold effect to the gray layer, and it ends up being the same. Again, the blur effect, adjusting that will cause the difference in the rounding, but this will be exactly the same size as the matte plane that is underneath it. Okay, so exactly. So you can actually dial that in to the pixel. So those are the three super simple ways of making a rounded corner rectangle in HitFilm. This is Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. If you like this kind of thing, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.